Shut up, man. Sorry, I'm gonna stuff you. Just me?
You're gonna take the glove off?
Nope. I'm sleeping right now. This is second egg. Never mind.
88.
You get that?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like that, you dwarf.
Seven.
We have a few sevens here.
Six doesn't count, that counts as a seven.
What? I had that many 88s of second inning?
Seven.
That's your seven. Two ones, two sliders.
She doesn't want to go home. She doesn't want to see Caleb.
Dang, bro.
Bigfoot is not real.
Where's it going? Huh?
Getting radar, bro?
Three.
Seven.
Stinky boy pollen.
103.
Is that not strike three?
103.
Shut up, dude. Sorry.
Did you guys notice that the first batter
you say that was
103.
The second batter I faced, actually.
What was that?
That last one's 87.
The second batter I faced, their third base coach thought the kid was 1-2. And on the umpire, had him at like 3-0.
Hey, Simon. I accidentally absolutely drilled Sean's thumb on that spike fastball. I felt really bad.
Connor just struck that kid out.
He was like, yeah.
No, he walked him.
No, he struck him out. He threw six pitches.
No, he walked him.
Six pitches.
He walked him.
Dead ass, he threw three strikes on fastballs.
He walked him.
Yeah.
He's on first.
What?
You had double nine.
Just like my pickoff. I picked off twice today. Frick, bro.
94.
Count it.
Count it.
Yeah, you can do that.
We're counting this, right?
That was kind of like your 91. I think you're at the exit, bro.
Somebody take this.
You better not see it to me ever again. Dude, I would literally come in a crime right here. I need to touch your mouth.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. 87.
Right down 87.
I agree with you.
I feel shaking right now, bro. Full time, everybody would be up.
I think that 91 was because I took my pre-workout at optimal time.
86.
I can't write right now. I'm shaking.
Cause we can't write.
This should be a common problem with your pitching stick. It can
work too. Caffeine addicts.
I got enough caffeine in me to kill an elephant.
We're caffeine addicts.
Take it easy on your roommate, dude. You're Eli's roommate, right?
Dude.
I'm Matt's dad, sorry.
Oh, God.
You guys.
Oh, man.
I got my police scanner. It says, another police raid at the Legends. No, I'm just kidding you.
It's always Ian.
Yeah, it's definitely me.
You guys are on the other side from like where my friend Sean Troy.
They live in the estate.
Oh, you're in the rich part.
No, I'm at the Legends. Oh. I'm at the building right over.
Porky's at the States.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
What do you mind living in the States? Nice.
Oh, yeah.
They're like the same price as Legends.
Really?
Yeah.
Legends are dumb.
Yeah, my buddy's parents are reading. How much you pay?
$41.
Me and my buddy's school. It's like.
Bro, what was their reading on
it?
Sometimes I just signals.
Or it's like.
I guess I shouldn't complain too much then because Matthew and Sean Tram, it's like $16.50 a month.
Last year, I was at a private JUCO last year, and so they could run like the, you could run that through the school.
Oh, nice.
So you didn't have to like do it on your own, they could set it for you. But they overcharged so much. It was a two-bedroom apartment, I had three roommates, and
you were
like,
in Wisconsin or something?
Milwaukee. And it was $2,400 in the morning.
Really?
Yeah, it was expensive. Really nice apartment.
Well,
but it's just like,
they use that term luxury a lot too loosely.
Yeah, the market just seems to be.
So who's the other guy? I don't have to worry about any damage there's already
I like living on my own now.
He saves time.
been, he's like, on your own on that?
But it's like, you know, I'm trying to win that one.
Yeah, shit, my kid moved down to the 13th. This is second year. Yeah.
Really?
Did you see Cozart was in the
93 sophomore? Yep.
Yeah. COVID comes out.
He's disgusting.
What are you in graduate?
Sam Cozart?
Must have been coming freshman.
That's not bad.
Because he's older. As I say, I'm 20.
Have you seen him?
All right, Adam Connor, let's go, babe.
I don't want my kid going to Juco for 5 years, 6 months, because I'm paying the bill. I mean, we had kids on this team last year.
I just think it's going to just be like
35.
I was thinking about like retro, but it's just like a year of money.
No, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well, where I'm from, it's like I had no exposure. When I had to reach out, and it was usually
like, how are they going to get the money? I saw you throwing down at Fox.
It's
just
inflated. It is. But I'm not. It's like, how are they going to offer me, you know, if they haven't seen me play? Just for like a little bit.
The nice thing is pitching. You guys have the number.
Yeah. Once you have to see what you're saying,
it's pretty easy.
I literally had.
Here's the thing, too. The only school's going to be enrolled its way down.
Yeah, it's kind of
if he's, but it's like, if he's actually a 15, 16, I think it's impossible. I don't think I've ever seen a scout until I got to college. But like, every kid in my area gets beat to each first semester because they don't play.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got crap for those people. They're like, what is Paluco? I'm going to go to a real college. I'm like, so, trying to be a dork like you. I'm trying to do that one.
I grew up playing baseball in California. Juco would beat the shit out of me.
Nah, same as Juco.
I think if I was D1 out of high school, I'd still get a Juco for a year.
You know, several of his high school teammates,
that was out of
pocket. They didn't even make it to the league.
I think it'd be like you're going from high school to college. You got to be an actual stud, like a crazy stud to actually get the playing time.
It's not like the old days where you get you in there as a freshman and they kind of ruin you when you get older. If you don't perform day one, you
that's why I love Juco so much. It's like, even if you go for a year, you get a whole fall, like pretty much no dead period.
I remember like same on Twitter.
Oh, just raps and live ABs, and you're still facing these guys.
Yeah, I mean, all the D2 school right here,
I'm just going to hope I get drafted and drop to the
bottom. It's a good ink.
Come on, boy!
74.
Let's just start by helping these guys. I mean, they got like two or three returning pitchers. Last year, JD was redshirted.
Brent was redshirted.
Yeah, but he's hurt. He's got to say. He was a very good senior. That's a good point.
I'm not going to find any good.
I love pitching. I love pitching.
Just my seat. Harvey's on the
road. He's on the road.
I like teams that play
with
big dicks.
He worked with Matthew a little bit last year. He's like, yeah, Charlie's a genius.
So, I wish ECU had a
last year was really frustrating. My pitching coach was pretty smart, but one thing was like, super lazy. I was talking to my buddy on the team. He's as a freshman, he went 0 for 11 in spring, and then went off and then led our team average. That ended by 370. And he was like a starting center fielder. Easily could go through. And this year he's talking to me, he goes, yeah, of course, being like a dink right now.
It's the same, he's on the same people team.
Yeah. And he said like,
oh, you were that Brian Stratton, right?
Yeah.
They got a bunch of those. They got a bunch of those.
Right, so now
they come rolling up with those buses.
Yeah, they.
Because we knocked them out in Region 10. They're one from Virginia.
Yeah, our coach is just dink. Like one night we lost a game we probably should have won. He's like, 3-hour drive. He's like, yeah, Edens were winners.
Really?
Yeah. Dude, we were all starving. Not starving.
Yeah.
Looking at him with type 1 diabetes. He's like, bro, I need food.
Why not?
He's eating peanuts off the floor. Yeah, he was like, I pretty much taught myself in the pitch last year. So it's like such a blessing.
So everything he had to
do.
Yeah. It was like last year was probably the most frustrating thing ever.
So you pitched much in high school?
Like two and a half.
So you won fresh.
I went as a hitter. Couldn't really catch up to the competition.
But you're smart.
Yeah.
Because there's an option.
So like I was throwing. I got to college and they're like, I should throw a bullpen. And I was like, middle age. Good movement. And I was like, all right, I'll be like, I can get two-way for now. But it's like, all right, that sounds good. And then January,
Max Piper.
I was like,
Ferrum maybe.
86, 88.
So how did you end up here? Did they reach out to you? Because usually Wisconsin has
been. All right, so it's actually a really funny story how I found out about this place. I was in the. It's a really weird story. So I followed this dude on TikTok. And he was like a Christian minister. And he made this Snapchat story. And anybody could join it. So it was like 2,000 kids in it. And basically just like a bunch of Christian. I posted it, and this kid added me on Snap. He was like, hey, you want to have this one? Like, he added this group chat, just a bunch of Christian guys trying to help each other faith. And I was like, yeah, sure.
That's weird, though. Like, we're still loving it. We're really good friends.
I talked to one of the kids out of the group chat, too.
I texted him, Ryan guy, because he followed me on Twitter.
He was like, spring break, I had nothing going on. I was like, you know, let's set up a trip.
Oh, nice.
I went to Wyatt. It was like the past week of my life.
I went to
That's peace.
Mysterious ways.
Everybody I met has been good friends with like that week. Yeah. So I came down 3 more times. He went to CVCC, but like just and then I was like, I have to be like, I can't get
up
here.
Where is he now? Did he move out to the
players? He's in Sacramento. But I'm not sure if what's your favorite? So yeah, I moved out and I looked up CVCC's program and I'm like, no, but where are they at? They're good to go. Like a top tier program. And it was actually scary as hell. I told my coach last year, I was like, I'm planning on moving regardless. I play baseball or not. And if you can reach out to the coach, like, I really appreciate that. Because like, even if I don't play baseball, I'm still moving. And he's like, all right, yeah, I'm 100% on this offer. And that was in February. And then,
visual.
Matthew played some of them this year in campus in a small town in Barnard. And he was playing in the Rolly area. Turns out, like, his buddy was going to
Mountain. Yeah, I know. End of the season comes around, my coach goes, hey, you still want me to reach out? 4 months ago, I talked to you. Yeah. Like, you know, he did that with every kid on the team. Like, half our sophomores,
well, if there's nothing going
for me, I think two kids had genuine offers, and they didn't reach out to me.
Helps your program. If you're going to go somewhere, you're going to stay
They had a losing record every year.
No, I could see every day.
And like last year, we easily could have went to the series. Like we had the talent.
Just come coach here coach right off the bat.
Just bring me their house.
I really killed. So I'm like, all right, I'm not trusting the coach no more. So in June, I had a really good bullpen. When I was 8-7 in the morning. I emailed Don. And I was like, I just had a response.
Oh, yeah. It would be like,
sure. Within a day, I was on the team. So yeah, you know, he was like, yeah, we'd like you on our team. I was like, I was working the bill.
What are you guys doing? Just getting kids to practice.
Is that my other crossbow? Is that my other crossbow?
No, I found it.
That was 81. That was 81. Is that change up? Is that change up? Is that change up? Is that change up? There's also an 80. We're going to hit an 80.
He's left. I
think I saw like two lefties my entire life.
I was going to say, yeah, it's tough because like you don't see him growing up. But then you get in big leagues, it's like you
never see him. All I have to do is hit up a coach. That's why I get something cool about him. And then I have to draft him.
Ready to go. Are you
okay? Yeah, that like crossbow read.
Okay.
I released him one through. That's what I was like. Yeah, and something was like shifted in there. I didn't feel. I was like scared to do that. Feels.
I hear they're cooking up some steak and lobster tails.
Something like that, yeah.
You're fine.
Tomorrow, I think I'm up to a